Session on Wien bridge oscillator. I am Mrs.V.S.Kulkarni Kulkarni. Learning outcomes are: at the end of session, students will be able to analyze the Wien bridge oscillator circuit. Contents are like this: basic principle for the Wien bridge oscillator. As it is a part classification of RC oscillator, it consists of the network, two-stage amplifier which provides 360 degree phase shift. Next, output of this two-stage amplifier is given to the bridge circuit which consists of RC network, that is series and parallel combination of RC and two more RC network forming a Wien bridge circuit, which is used to stabilize the output of oscillator. This further is given to the input of two-stage amplifier. So here, total phase shift of 360 degree is obtained with this two-stage amplifier and will be maintained such that sustained oscillations can be obtained. So Wien bridge oscillator is a circuit which provides you the sine waves at the output with the frequency range of 20 Hz to 20 kHz. So it is also called as type of audio oscillator. So this is the basic block diagram of Wien bridge oscillator circuit, where total phase shift is obtained through the two stages of amplifier and bridge circuit is used to just stabilize the output. Figure 2 shows the circuit diagram for Wien bridge oscillator circuit. Due to the thermal noise of the active and passive elements, noise gets generated in the circuit and that gets amplified and further given to the transistor Q2, which amplifies your signal as well as phase shift it with the 180 degree. So this 180 degree plus 180 degree phase shift signal, that is which is in phase with the input, is provided to the bridge circuit. In this bridge circuit, you can observe this is your R1C1 series combination and R2C2 parallel combination, which gives the positive feedback, nothing but regenerative effect, and R4 resistor will provide you degenerative effect, that is negative feedback, which gives the amplitude stability to the output. So this bridge gets balanced at particular condition and then you are providing this signal through this circuit, and that is at the base of transistor Q1. So we can say here VF is given to transistor Q1 and V0 is given to the bridge circuit. So here output of Q2 is fed back to the bridge circuit. R4 provides a degenerative effect, R2 provides regenerative effect, which is in parallel combination with C2. C1 and C2 variations will give you the change in the value of frequency, so it will decide the value of frequency, whereas R1 and R2 variations will decide the change in the range of frequency. Now we will see the expression for gain and frequency of oscillation. So here, Wien bridge oscillator circuit. As R1 and R2 are connected in series, we can write it as R plus 1 by j omega c, whereas parallel combination can be written as Z equal to R by 1 plus j omega c R. So when your bridge gets balanced, then its arm resistance will be equal to R3 divided by R1 plus 1 by j omega C1. This is equal to R4 divided by parallel combination of R2 and C2, that is nothing but R2 by 1 plus j omega C2 R2. After simplification or after cross multiplication and the simplification of the equation by separating the real and imaginary part, you will get the equation like this. R2 R3 minus R1 R4 minus R2 R4 C2 divided by C1 plus, now the imaginary part, that is J R4 by omega C1 minus R2 C2 R1 R4 omega. This is imaginary part of the equation, that is R4 by omega C1 minus R2 C2 omega R1 R4. Now, when you equate this imaginary part to zero, you will obtain the frequency of oscillations for the Wien bridge oscillator circuit. So, here R4 by omega C1 equal to R2 C2 R1 R4 omega. So, we can write here omega square equal to R4 by R2 C2 R1 R4. So, we can see here the value of, so you have to take the C1 also to this side. So, you will get this omega C1 here. So, only omega over here. So, it will be C1. So, if you consider the values of resistance, that is R1 equal to R2 equal to R and C1 equal to C2 equal to C, then all these values will become same. So, you can write omega square equal to R square C square. Therefore, omega is what? 2 pi f. So, f can be written as 1 by 2 pi rc. 1 by 2 pi rc. Gain. How to obtain the value of gain? So, you can see here. Again, look at the bridge circuit. Here, as you know, Vf is there at the base of Q1 and V0 is applied through C3 to the bridge circuit. So, as you know, Z1 is the series combination of resistor and capacitor. So, it will be R1 minus J XC1. Z2 is parallel combination. So, it will be minus J R2 XC2 by R2 minus, and Vf equal to V0 into Z2 by Z1, Z2 by Z1 plus Z2. So, beta is nothing but ratio of Z2 by Z1 plus Z2. So, here Z2 is minus J R2 by XC2 divided by Z1 plus Z2. So, that is Z1 is R1 minus J XC1 plus, this is Z1 plus Z2, that is minus J R2 XC2 by R2 minus J XC2. So, here R2 minus J XC2. So, when you simplify this equation and further you assume R1 equal to R2 equal to R and XC1 equal to XC2 equal to XC. So, you will come across the equation for beta like this, that is 1 divided by 3 plus J into bracket R by XC minus XC by R. Simply separate out the real and imaginary part over here and see here, beta will be 1 by 3 plus J into bracket R by XE minus XE by R. So if you consider the real part over here, so you will get beta equal to 1 by 3, and the condition for sustained oscillation is AV beta must be greater than 1. So AV should be greater than or equal to 1 upon beta. 1 upon beta is 3. So we can say here, when voltage gain of two stages of amplifier is greater than 3, then and then sustained oscillations can be obtained. So this is the condition for gain for Wien bridge oscillator circuit. Now recall, a Wien bridge oscillator circuit generates the oscillation only if gain of two stage amplifier greater than 3. Yes, this is the correct answer. Now, why is the negative feedback provided in the Wien bridge oscillator circuit? Through the resistors, you are providing the negative feedback. And answer is to stabilize the amplitude of output. Applications of Wien bridge oscillator, as it is providing the 0 degree phase shift through the bridge circuit, so it is used for generating the 0 degree stable oscillator related circuitry. It is very good for the audio applications where stability of frequency and amplitude is obtained through the two stages of amplifier and the bridge circuit. It is used for the distortion testing in power amplifiers, also used for excitation for AC bridge. It is very useful to fabricate the pure tune because it's a very special type of audio oscillator circuit. As we are using the bridge circuit over here, it is used to measure the audio frequency of signal. References are like this. Thank you.